Hey everybody, Devin from Abundant Life Church here. Just wanted to reach out and talk to you guys about our transition process over this next month or so. As many of you know that this Friday, Berks County is going from red to yellow. And that means we're switching from a season of quarantine to a season of transition. Starting on June 7th, this Sunday, we will be reopening our church for those who feel comfortable to come and worship. That's very exciting. We are going from one service to three services so that we can practice social distancing. Two services will be on Sunday morning, 9 and 11. We'll ask people to wear masks as they enter and exit, but it'll only be optional during the service. On Thursday night, starting this Thursday, June 4th at 7 p.m., we'll have a special service for people who are higher risk. All people who come will be asked to wear masks, and we will temperature scan everybody just to make sure maximum safety for everyone who attends here. So what's the heart behind this? Shouldn't we just wait a little longer? Shouldn't we just play it safe, Devin? Do we really need to start right away? Well, I believe we need to use wisdom, and we've been really thinking through all of our decisions with wisdom and praying for wisdom. We released a safety guidelines that many of you are getting in the mail, or you saw on our internet, or will see on our internet, that we have out that you can read. And those guidelines list out the different decisions we are making. But when it comes to playing it just safe, normally God's word doesn't just call us to just play safe. It calls us to step out of faith and take a risk sometimes. We can look at the 10 spies in Numbers who played it safe and didn't want to go in the promised land because it looked dangerous and they missed out on what God had for them. And we're in this transition season, right? And as people are trying to figure out what going back to a normal life looks like, we believe that it should be the church's responsibility to help lead people out of this quarantine into a place of transition. That the church shouldn't just sit back and wait for society to do that, but it's our responsibility to help lead people to where they need to be. Listen, the church has always been a safe place for people, right? The church has always been known as a place where people can go and feel safe. And we believe that as we do these services, that our services on Sunday morning and on Thursday nights will be a safe place for you, that as you start to just take steps outside of your house and outside of your quarantine, as you feel comfortable and you feel ready, we hope and pray that just as much as you walk into a Walmart or a grocery store because you believe, hey, it's fairly safe there, that you would think even more, hey, I believe that my church will be a safe place. That we know that there are many people who are struggling emotionally, mentally, and spiritually due to this quarantine. And if that's you, we want you to know that we're here, that we love you, and we're ready to let God use us to touch and fill your lives. Also, we will be having children's ministry starting this Sunday, June 7th, for children 5th grade and all the way down to infants. This will only be during the 11 a.m. service. All of our workers in children's ministry and throughout the church, all of our volunteers will be temperature checked. And we believe kids can grow in their faith in a very safe, clean environment. So if that's something you feel comfortable with, we want you to know, parents, that's available to you. And for those who are not ready yet, for those who might be a higher risk situation, either because of health or because of age, we want you to know that nothing is changing. We will continue to live stream all of our services. We will continue to reach out. We'll continue to be there for everyone. We want you to know you can reach out to us at any time. We love you, church. We care for you. We're praying for you. And thank you for praying for us in this difficult time. And thank you that we cling and hold together as a church. I want to just read over you Isaiah chapter 30. Isaiah 30, 18 says, "Therefore the Lord waits to be gracious to you. And therefore he exalts himself to show you mercy. For the Lord is a God of justice, and blessed are those who wait for him." Church, as you make this decision, I encourage you, wait for him. Let the Lord speak to you as to when you're ready, and continue to seek him with all your heart and know that he is there for you. Church, we're living in some difficult times right now as a nation, and we need to be on our knees in prayer, believing that he is going to do a great work in and through our lives. Thank you, church.